Award, and this is our third year competing as a team. Along with overcoming the challenges of performing on the field this year, we had a clear vision of what we wanted to accomplish. First, we wanted to continue to expand and deepen our skill set in areas such as MathCAD, PTC, and Android. Next, we wanted to continue to learn mechanical design from local industrial experts. And finally, as a veteran team, we really wanted to make a positive impact in our community by hosting our very own league with Ortop and by mentoring rookie teams. But first, let's talk robot.
Our initial strategy this season was to climb up to the middle of the ramp and hang and score from there. To do this, we invested 2 months to test and experiment different sprocket wheel designs. We had over 10 designs of this, and each had a different number of sprockets and a different angle between each one. As you can see in this video, it was really time-consuming to drive up to the middle of the ramp, and our robot had a lot of trouble tipping over while going over the churros. We tried fixing this by lowering the frame angle, but it still took around 15 seconds to drive up and down the ramp. And because of this, we decided to try a new strategy.
We realized that traveling up the ramp every single time we wanted to score was slow and inefficient. So we decided to create a latching mechanism to hook onto the first bar and then use a two-stage linear slide system to both score blocks and hang. In order to create the optimal latching mechanism, we went through 3 iterations, and now we can consistently score 4 to 5 blocks in the high or middle goal in 10 to 15 seconds. And we can score the shelter climbers, the beacon, and the zipline climbers every match.
Now that we had a consistent scoring mechanism, we decided to focus on hanging. So as you can see, our hanging system is composed of a 2-stage linear slide with a 1-stage rubber band loaded pop-out with 3 sets of hooks at the end. And as you can see in this video, each of these sets of hooks serves a different purpose. The outer set of hooks hooks onto the hanging bar and pulls the robot from the low zone to the mid zone of the rim. Then, the drivers readjust the hanging system, and the inner set of hooks, again, hooks onto the hanging bar and brings the robot into hanging position. And as the second part is happening, the middle set of hooks hits the all clear signal down. So this is all built into one very smooth, coherent design that gives us a huge competitive advantage in endgame.
This year's challenge was very complex, so we needed 3D rather than just 2D analysis. We used PTC through every stage of our design, specifically to analyze different frame angles and make sure our buggy could reach the high goal without our robot tipping over. The different iterations of wheels shown earlier were all designed, printed, and positioned using PTC, and we also used MathCAD to do stress calculations for our linear slides as well as other calculations for our robot.
This year, control was essential in our robot. In autonomous, we used multiple different sensors, including encoders on all of our drive motors for effective movement, as well as a gyro sensor for effective turning and scoring the climbers. In addition, we have 4 different color sensors on the back of our robot for detecting the beacon. In teleop, we used multiple different algorithms and sensors. Back when our bucket had 2 degrees of freedom, we used an inverse kinematics algorithm so that the drivers would just have to specify an X and Y coordinate on the mountain plane, and then the bucket mouth would automatically move to that position for easy scoring. However, since our bucket has evolved, we no longer use that. In addition, we have limit switches and encoders all around our arm so that the drivers have presets to effectively score in teleop.
This year as a team, we have committed to over 1,500 hours of outreach. We have hosted 11 events and been invited to several others to help promote FIRST, ORTOP, and STEM in our communities. One example of this would be the Intel Rondler Acres trip. During this outreach, we showcased our robot at the ORTOP booth at the fair, allowing both kids and adults to drive our robot. Furthermore, we provided handouts for those who were interested in creating new teams. As a result, we helped create 3 new teams as well as providing basic information of STEM back to our community. Another example is how we have hosted 5 league meets, 2 super qualifiers, and helped in 2 state championships in 2 different states. The result of this is that we have gave the opportunity to multiple teams to experience the way of the league meet system, we have allowed several rookie teams to compete, and we have also coordinated many volunteers. Our team also reached out to Oregon State Representative, as well as the Oregonian and the Valley Times, our local press, to share our experience at FIRST with them. As a result and overall outcome, we have not only promoted FIRST in our communities, but ORTOP and basic concepts of STEM.
In addition to promoting FIRST, another aspect of our outreach includes reaching out to large industry experts. A main focus of our outreach is how we organize events that gave opportunities to other teams. An example would be our visit to a local automotive design center. We talked with some officials of the company and organized a tour in which many people came to, where we learned about some possible future careers. Lastly, we wanted to expand our outreach beyond our home state of Oregon, so we drove 6 hours to a neighboring state to help with their state competition, where we helped teams who had trouble with their robots, as well as filling in volunteer roles for the event.
In the past few minutes, we've been able to show all of the functions and features of a robot, but we haven't been able to express the amount of work that we've put into it. For example, 10 iterations of our drivetrain, 5 iterations of our bucket, and 3 iterations of our slide system. With these many iterations, we started off at League Meet 0 with a score of 0. We then kept on progressing throughout our tournaments and scored the Oregon FTC state record with 456 points. We then scored 500 points at the West Super Regional Championship. With all these scores, we are now ranked in the top 10 on FTCstats.org and hope to score above 600 points with our partner at this competition. Now, I know that was a lot of information to handle, but if you have any questions, please feel free to ask. Thank you.